Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. You look at the SSGI graph from the previous time frame with a threshold of magnitude 5.5. This is the seismic activity that we had. We had a critical planetary geometry on the 2nd of July, including Mercury, Sun, Neptune in a conjunction. And I estimated that we could see an obvious seismic increase. There was a 5.7, that was the largest tremor actually on the 4th. Remember, I said 3, 4 and 5 July. On the 4th, 5.7, it was actually part of a significant cluster of earthquakes, mostly moderate earthquakes off the coast of Vancouver Island. And there were some 5-pointers as well. It peaked 5.7. And you may recall that I mentioned the Cascadia subduction zone as an example. There is obvious stress building along the Cascadia subduction zone. This is along the northern part, the Wanda-Fuca plate, which is an old remnant of a plate that's diving under the North America plate. And this clustering tells us that there is stress building along a Cascadia subduction zone. Again, only a 5.7. It could have been a single larger earthquake. Instead, we had a cluster. We had a new moon on the 5th, followed by a planetary conjunction with Mercury. That was Mercury, Sun and Mars. And I said that there could be some seismic increase there as well, but not all that much. We did have an obvious cluster, magnitude 5.5 at larger earthquakes. It peaked 6.2 deep below the Bonin Island south of Japan. This obvious clustering of strong earthquakes, that's a clear sign that there is this relationship between planetary geometry, critical planetary geometry, as depicted here by this SSGI graph, and larger seismic activity. And the larger earthquakes, typically what we indicate is 5.5, 5.6. That's what we use as a threshold, and that's what we see here on the SSGI graph. This is all the activity that we had. So if you look at this SGI graph, we see from the 30th up until the 4th, there is no larger seismic activity. So whenever you hear someone say we have a 5.5 every 1 or 2 days, what they actually mean is we have a 5.5 on average. It is not reality. In reality, stronger earthquakes tend to cluster. And I cannot stress this enough. Stronger earthquakes tend to cluster following specific planetary and lunar geometry, and that's perfectly depicted here on this SGI graph. And we have many examples of this. Okay, let's have a look at the coming time frame up until the 18th of July. I briefly mentioned in the previous update a right angle geometry on the 9th, that was yesterday. It's not actually right angle geometry, it is semi-right angle geometry. That means with Mercury and Venus, 45 and 135 degrees. And we had the critical one yesterday morning, that was Venus, at 135 degrees with Mercury and Uranus. And it's followed, it usually comes in pairs, and we see this morning Mercury at 45 degrees with Venus and Uranus. Mercury-Venus in combination should never be underestimated, in particular with Uranus. And it can be a conjunction, it can be right angle or semi-right angle. That's the specific geometry that we look at. This morning, following this geometry, we had actually a 6.6, some agencies reported 6.7 south of Africa. And it followed, followed on the semi-right angle geometry with Venus, Venus in particular. And tomorrow we have lunar geometry coming up. That's with Saturn and also with Neptune. And the lunar geometry, that's a conjunction or actually an opposition with Neptune, that converges with Venus, Mars and Neptune in a conjunction. And there can be a seismic response there around the 13th. It could be a cluster of stronger earthquakes approaching magnitude 6. It can also be a single larger earthquake. There's a geometry of significance in the first half of this time frame. Then on the 15th, we have Earth, Mars and Uranus in a conjunction that can quickly result in a single stronger earthquake, possibly mid-6 magnitude, around the 16th. And then you see a high lunar peak. That is because the moon will be in opposition. That's what we call a conjunction in our simplified terms. That's Moon, Earth, Mars and Moon, Earth, Uranus, and there's only 1.5 hours in between. So this geometry happens virtually at the same time, and that's why you see a single larger lunar peak. And then we have the Moon also in opposition with Jupiter. That's later on the 17th, early 18th. And in between, we have Sun, Venus and Uranus at a right angle. That geometry is not all that critical, but the lunar geometry, that can be followed by a seismic increase, could be a single stronger earthquake, and or just some seismic increase. That very much depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust, which is what we do not know. So we can see some seismic increase following that lunar geometry. That could be our 18th or 19th. It may not be all that much, but again, be on extra alert following that lunar geometry, especially because Jupiter is the largest planet. And we've recently seen with the 7.2 in Peru that followed on a lunar conjunction with Saturn. So Jupiter and Saturn, that should not be underestimated with the lunar geometry. And that's the geometry that we are going to have. A quick look at the solar system. We see Venus here in the spotlight, the purple lines indicating the conjunction with Mars and Neptune coming up, and also the semi-right angle geometry that we had yesterday and today. Okay, this is the update for now. We still have problems with atmospheric fluctuations since this spring, actually, and that is because sensors broke, and we still have difficulty in recalibrating them and getting good results. We do not know actually why that is. We did see some fluctuations in the atmosphere, in unrest in the atmosphere before the 6.6, 6.7 South of Africa this morning. So we picked them up yesterday, but we cannot really determine what the most likely areas are at the moment. So we are working on that, and we hope to be able to provide good results as soon as possible. Again, check out the website for the latest updates and also our social media channels. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.